Welcome back, Earthlings, to another episode of the Amateur Space Archaeologist. I'm your host, Anthony Steinhardt. This episode will take a look at the two geoglyphs found in the Fort Mohave area of Arizona. What is a geoglyph, some of you may ask? Well, a geoglyph is a large-scale image or design produced in the natural landscape by techniques such as aligning rocks or gravel, or by removing soil or sod, the complete form of which is only visible from the sky or at a distance. Some of the most famous geoglyphs in the world are the Nazca lines in Peru. Now, a quick note about the different spelling of Fort Mohave, Arizona, and the Mojave Indian tribe. It could come down to a simple clerical error for the spelling of Fort Mohave. However, it is more likely that the evolution of the name Mojave followed the natural phonetic process, since the American language does not have an equivalent of the Spanish-sounding J and instead substitutes the sound with an H. Whatever the reason is, the United States Geological Survey's Geographic Names Information System recognizes both spellings, Mojave with an H being accepted in Arizona and Mojave with a J being the accepted spelling in California. With all of that out of the way, let us take a closer look at the Fort Mojave area of Arizona, which is located 99 miles from the Las Vegas Strip and approximately 14 miles from Laughlin, Nevada. Fort Mojave was once occupied by the Mojave Indians, also known as the Pipa Aha Macav, or the people by the river. They traced their origins to Spirit Mountain, the highest peak in the nearby Newberry Mountains. According to the tribe's tradition, their spirit mentor was known as Matavilia, created at the time when heaven and earth met. By some varying accounts, Matavilia's sister or daughter, known as the Frog Woman, killed him before he was able to teach his people all they needed to know about the world. It is then that his brother or son, Mastamho, took charge and created the Colorado River by driving a willow stick into the ground. He gave the Mojave people the river and everything along the river, as well as instructed the tribe in the arts of civilization. One of the first people to document meeting the Mojave tribe was Friar Francisco Hermenegildo Tomas Garces in his diary back in 1776 while on expedition with Lieutenant Colonel Juan Bautista de Anza. De Anza would go on to establish the first settlements of San Francisco, while Garces would take the honor of being the first non-Native American to pass through modern-day Nevada. By 1848, Arizona, which was still a part of New Mexico, was annexed by the United States, and with that came more settlers and the U.S. Army onto Mojave land, upsetting the native people of the area. And in 1858, an attack by a local native group on a wagon train led to a military expedition in 1859 headed by Lieutenant Colonel William Hoffman of the 6th U.S. Infantry against the Mojave Indians. Once Lieutenant Colonel Hoffman arrived, he dictated a peace with the Mojave chiefs, threatening annihilation if they did not comply and cease all hostilities. During this time in 1859, an American military outpost was established, originally named Camp Colorado, before quickly being renamed Fort Mojave. The purpose of the fort was to ensure the safe passage of wagon trains of emigrants and soldiers passing through the area. Continued skirmishes with the Mojave Indians led Major Lewis A. Armistead to formulate a major campaign of retribution against the River Tribe. With the Americans' vastly superior firepower, killing or maiming a large number of the Mojave's most able-bodied men, the Mojaves decided to accept a peace deal. As part of the peace deal, the Mojaves had to give up a small parcel of land, and even though the area amounted to just a few acres, for the Mojaves, they had just lost their homeland. The fort, however, was abandoned in 1861 during the early part of the Civil War, reopened in 1863, and in 1890 it was turned over to the Fort Mohave Indian Reservation for use as a school. The school was closed in 1930 and the buildings were demolished in 1942. While I was searching for the remains of the fort, I came across the two geoglyphs that had my initial interest in the area of Fort Mojave, Arizona. To my surprise, the geoglyphs were located just outside a residential area. According to some researchers, the geoglyphs represent the hero twins of the Mojave tribe's creation myth. They are thought to be the brother deities of Mastamho and Katar, with the larger of the two representing good and the smaller one without a head, representing evil. However, I cannot find any more info about Katar. Perhaps he's been lost to history, as it has been suggested that the geoglyphs could be 1,000 years old or more, with no definitive answer to their age. Sticking with the good and evil theme, could the geoglyphs represent Mastamho and the Frog Woman instead of Katar? When I look at the geoglyphs, the headless one looks more to me like a frog. There seems to be a head shape, just no neck, and the legs and arms look more frog-like. I'm just speculating. Obviously, this site was of great importance to the people who placed these geoglyphs here. What took place here in the distant past? Was this a marker to ward off evil or let other tribes know that they have entered Mojave space? Hopefully, one day we'll have a greater understanding of this site. However, as more time passes, our memories tend to fade and stories forgotten. I hope I've inspired the citizen scientists inside of you to start exploring the world around you, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click the bell icon. Until next time, thanks for watching the Amateur Space Archaeologist.